The engines of Sodor carry their trains in different ways, most commonly and preferably from the front, while occasionally pushing them from behind. But none of them like to be a middle engine. It's the most disorderly way to transport passengers and goods across the island. It was midday, and the Scottish twins were discussing the trouble old Spiteful had caused.
I'm glad the Fat Controller won't be giving him another chance, but I'm still trying to comprehend how someone could be inspired by that horribly, dastardly, devious diesel. Aye, that is concerning Dougie. You don't think his influence could spread to the minds of other diesel engines? I dinny ken, Donny. But I'd say they'd be a wee bit steaming in the head if they think they could get away with upsetting the mighty stout gentleman. After the way he spoke to old Spiteful when he sent him off to the scraps, they better skedaddle after themselves.
Before the twins could crack any more jokes, Oliver whimpered into the station, looking very sulky.
What's with you, little Ollie? Playing middle engine?
Not by choice. The Smelter twins have been shunting trucks in front of us and it's been causing a great deal of confusion and delay.
Now that you mention it, I have noticed a lot of middle engines in recent days. If it's such a problem, then inform the worthy Sir Topham Hatt. He ought to sort out those scabby rajahs himself.
That's the problem. They have a system where one does a shunting while the other keeps watch. Therefore, they immediately flee the scene as soon as they are spotted. Donald and Douglas worried that Diesel's influence may be worse than they thought, but they didn't know what to do. That afternoon, Douglas arrived at the yard to collect his train when the Smelter twins oiled up to him.
It's nothing personal, mate.
We're only doing this for our missing companion.
What are you bucky-scented diesels on about? We want to know what happened to Devious Diesel. He was leading our cause to be rid of you, tin kettles.
He has been missing for too long. Surely the Fat Controller would know what happened to him.
Have you even bothered to ask him yourselves?
If we went up to him, he will surely spring a trap on us.
There will be no negotiations. The only way this can all subside is if he bends over to our demands.
Douglas, the middle engine, fumed out of the yard. He was already running late, which meant the hassle of sorting out his trucks would be extra daunting. When he finally arrived, Paxton, the friendly diesel, was there, resting in a siding.
Did Ari and Bird do that to you?
Yes, they did. Donnie told me how ye do not condone their disorderly ambitions.
That's right. These two diesels are why I've been misjudged as a scheming schmuck in the past, and it's been hurtful.
I feel sympathetic towards you. I'd rather see the return of his triplet of daredevils than to put up with these bloomin' bampot oil cans.
What are we going to do?
Let's be saying I don't have much to do for a while. The sooner I can capture those two, the sooner the good man's railway can return to order.
Douglas made a plan and shared it with the station master. Not long afterwards, the Smelter twins arrived at the station, unaware of Douglas's trap.
We're not getting anywhere with our plan, Harry. That stupid controller still believes he can capture us.
He is wasting his time. He knows what he must do in order to salvage Vestimi's diminishing reputation. But once he returns Diesel to us, Vestimi's salvation will become their annihilation. We cannot possibly lose this fight to create history of the day diesels ruled the railways. Imagine it now.
As Ari and Bert dreamed with their eyes closed, Douglas rolled slowly and quietly towards them with the goal to drag the diesels to the fat controller.
Ari! Watch out!
Oh, scrap! Let's get out of here!
Ah, diddly. I better try to catch one of them.
Down the line, Bill and Ben were quarreling over who should be in front of their trucks.
This isn't fair, Bill. You're supposed to be at the back this time. I'm always at the back doing our journeys to here. And I'm always stuck at the back doing our return journeys. I think it's time for a change. So I'm stuck in the back twice? I noticed you didn't mention this before we left, so we could have switched then. Now who could those two be? See? You always have an exciting perspective! Woo! Oops! Maybe I'll just stay back here.
But the crash was more severe than the tank engine twins realized. The smelter twins couldn't be more delighted.
That was absolutely fantastic, Bert! We took our silly steamy right there!
Maybe we don't need Diesel to help us. We can take them all out together.
Do not get too big for your buffers. Diesel is far more devious than we could ever be. We nearly got caught!
Oh, yes, forgive me, brother.
But if this doesn't persuade the Fat Controller to return Diesel to us, then we have the capability to take them out one by one. Our time draws near.
That night, Oliver and Donald talked about the shocking events that unfolded today.
How could this have happened? Dougie could have been damaged beyond repairs.
You know, Donald, for as long as we've known each other, I've never repaid Douglas for saving me from Scrap. And to think he is so close to entering that nightmarish place I laid it for so long.
These smelter diesels have gone too far. It was bad enough making us middle engines and delaying deliveries, but now they're actively trying to damage us!
It's like someone I looked up to suddenly needs my help.
Aye, if it's been weeks for the Fat Controller to catch them, and there is no way we can win this on our own. There was a long silence. Then Oliver spoke.
I may have an idea, Donald. It's risky and highly unlikely to work.
No time to doubt yourself, Ollie. This is for all of us now. If you have a plan, let's hear it.
So Oliver explained his plan to Donald. But I mustn't tell you anymore, or I shall spoil the next story.